目前已发现27例病例，其中7例病情严重，其余病例病情稳定可控，有2例病情。
In early 2020, as hospitals in Wuhan begin filling up with patients suffering from a new virus, medical services come under increasing strain.Over 42,000 doctors and nurses from around China come to give emergency assistance. In Jiangsu province, thousands step forward. This is the story of fighting a global pandemic through their eyes. A story of bravery, ingenuity, sacrifice, and the resilience of the human spirit.As groups of volunteers battled COVID-19, we tell the story of one team in the heart of the storm. Mid-February 2020. The novel coronavirus has now claimed over 1,000 lives in China. The World Health Organization that has been closely monitoring the situation is ready to formally name this disease.
We now have a name for the disease, and it is COVID-19, and I will spell it COVID-19. CO stands for corona, as you know. VI stands for virus, D for disease, so COVID.
In Wuhan, China, medics still battle to save patients. Amongst them is Dr. Pan Chuan.
这么多专家需要做几个事儿呢？第一个呢，就是防止这种感染的病人发展成有症状的病人。然后呢，第二个呢，就是说防止这种轻症的病人进展到重症。然后第三个呢，就是说防止重症的病人死亡。
One of his patients, 38-year-old Peng Bo, became critical. He is now sedated and receiving treatment. Before putting him under, Dr. Peng offered him some advice.
说你视频跟你家人说一下，然后说完聊聊天，不管你说什么吧，说完以后我再给你插管，然后去做治疗。当时还是挺，让我感觉还是压力也非常大。对于他来讲，能不能完全康复，或者再进一步讲，就是能不能活着从金银潭出去，作为我来说，我心里是没有数的。
Outside the hospital walls, Wuhan is now in lockdown, with almost 9 million people confined to their homes. But the virus is already in other parts of Hubei province.Hospitals are desperate for medical staff. So the government sets up a help system, partnering locations in this province with medics from across China. Once again, teams from Jiangsu province volunteer to help. Their destination is Huangshe, a city 100 kilometers to the southeast of Wuhan.At the Chengda Hospital in Nanjing, one medic who's signed up is Dr. Huang Yingzi. As chief physician in the critical care department, she and her team are not new to public health emergencies.
Because every time of this disaster, our department will directly participate. So at this time, everyone knows that it will come out at any time. No one says I won't go. Everyone is always ready.那么家里人基本上也都知道， 第二天可能就出发了。
On the 11th of February, Dr. Huang and her colleagues arrive in Huangshe. They are given a police escort through the silent streets and are welcomed at their hotel as VIPs.
Huangshe, we are 362 people from different hospitals.
As the head of the Jiangsu Medical Group in Huangshe, Dr. Huang leads teams at both the major hospitals in the city.
我们这些主任护长非常早的就自己先下病房，自己先去做很多具体的事情，所以就觉得这样一支真的可以叫队伍，似乎就是没有什么困难可以打得到。
By now, a group of experts organized by the National Health Commission have been working for almost a month to devise effective ways to treat patients. These protocols are continually updated and sent to medics like Dr. Huang.One of the key recommendations is that early intervention is crucial for a good recovery. So Dr. Huang knows there isn't a moment to lose.
早期呢，其实我们一直希望关口前移，就是不要让这样的病人来的时候是轻的，过两天是重的，然后再过几天是危重的。关口前移，移的就是这个。比如说有一个三十几岁的小伙子，他当时是非常紧张的。那么就跟他解释，就是说他的这个病情确实比来的时候要重一些，但是呢，你要有信心，因为你年轻，你的免疫力、抵抗力都在恢复中。那另外一个呢，我们就劝他，就是说在他可能的情况下做俯卧位，因为他经常躺着的话，靠近背部的很多的肺泡会塌陷。他有一天告诉我，我今天趴了四次，那么我就表扬他，我说你是执行这个执行最好的。呼吸锻炼，他刚开始说每次他憋的时候可能只能憋五到十秒，后面他说我可以憋个二三十秒了。
这状态比以前好多了，以前不能下床，不能翻身，就是基本上就是躺在那里不能动。
这样的病人其实是我们特别希望看到的，也特别喜欢看到的。
These ideas of intervening early and placing people in the prone position are crucial for patients. Developed in China, they would become part of the protocol for fighting the virus across the world. Dr. Huang is supported by a strong team, including nurse Li Xiaoqing. They go back a long way.
李小青呢是我们科的护士长，我和她是98年同时进科的。
As an experienced critical care nurse, Li Xiaoqing holds herself to the highest standards.
重症的医生应该是像移动打靶一样的，边瞄准边开枪。发给他信号的应该是我们护士，因为护士是守在病人床旁24小时都不会间断的。最先发现病情变化的一定应该是护士。如果让医生先发现了，比护士更早发现了，那我一定会觉得是我们在工作当中有失职的地方，没有做到位。
But even for her, the going is tough.
昨天收了个遗传的爷爷，之前还挺好的，然后查一个 CT， 可能稍微累了一下，然后就非常不好，氧合很不好。
After long days in the intensive care unit, she writes a diary, reflecting on her experiences.
下午路过九床的时候，看到叔叔的高流量管路有些牵拉，我走近一步问他：“我帮你调一下。”他的眼神一下子就亮了起来，忽然就激动了，对着我说：“谢谢，谢谢，谢谢你跟我说话，还愿意靠这么近帮我。”晴天的时候。我们还能看见病房走廊尽头的阳光，而他们能面对的就只有屋顶、墙壁和嘈杂无序的声音。哪怕只是在路过床旁的时候，稍稍地放慢脚步，轻轻地点一下头，或是跟他们说上一两句， 也会给他们带来希望，让他们觉得安心。
Keen to relieve the stress of her days, Nurse Lee also speaks regularly to her family back home.
妈，你最近工作忙不忙？每天工作的时间长吗？
还好吧，妈妈已经有点适应这里的情况了。早上8点坐车去，到下午5:00-6:00回来吧，大部分时候是这样。
那边吃的住的怎么样？
稀饭、肉包，还有一些点心，还挺好的，蛮舒服的。你看我都快长胖了。
Alongside Li Xiaoqing, another nurse who arrived from Jiangsu on the 11th of February is also focused on family, but not his own.
好了，我困了哦。
Ma Lang Chao is assigned to the Huangshe Maternal and Childcare Hospital to look after a special group of patients.
我有点不舒服。
In China, anyone who tests positive for the virus is monitored by medical staff in hospitals.Even those who have only mild symptoms, including children.
像那种3-4岁、4-5岁的就比较难对付，就是各种哄。
我有点不舒服。
Wearing 3 layers of PPE, even routine tasks have become extremely challenging for the nurses.
第一次打针嘛，戴着3层手套，戴着护目镜、面屏，护目镜里面再有一点。水蒸气，你根本就看不见。再加上那个小孩，他3个多月又比较胖，真的很难打。3年没打上，当天晚上我就给自己说了嘛，就像我一开始不会打针，然后我去第一次打针一样，去熟悉，保证成功率。
Apart from the physical challenges.The PPE also causes emotional barriers between the young patients and their medics.
因为儿童嘛，本身他来到这儿，你又不让他出去，然后每天还见着这么多怪叔叔、怪阿姨，穿着一身跟什么一样，跟奥特曼一样的东西，他其实是很恐惧的。
To better connect with the children, Ma Liang Chao and his colleagues soon find a solution.
这边有几个老师。画画比较好。我们有时候画皮卡丘，然后小青蛙，还有什么蜘蛛侠，他们会说：“哎呀，妈妈，那他身上是什么？”小孩就不那么排斥。你要走进他的世界，他想玩什么，你觉得他对什么感兴趣，你要跟他打成一片，他就比较听你的。
For Nurse Ma, his painted PPE is a precious memory of his time working with the children of Huangshe.
让他们。在防护服上画画，签上他们科室的名字，自己带回去做纪念。所以说，我觉得还是蛮有意义的吧。至少我穿着这身衣服，在这种情况下工作过，和他们并肩奋斗过。
In Wuhan, doctors are still under pressure to treat patients. So 16 field hospitals, known as cabin hospitals, are built in exhibition centers and stadiums, providing an extra 14,000 beds. Among the 16, the Dahuashan Cabin Hospital in Jiangsha District of Wuhan is uniquely entrusted to medics who specialize in the practice of traditional Chinese medicine.Or TCM, and this includes a team from Jiangsu province. In charge is Dr. Xu Suofang. At home in Nanjing, Dr. Xu is a chief physician and an experienced specialist in TCM. From the outset, he is confident he might be able to offer vital help to COVID-19 sufferers.
正好听到国家要做一个中医医疗队。从我自己来说，从事中医呼吸啊34年了，平时诊疗处理的就是这些呼吸道的疾病。那么这一次的新冠肺炎实际上 给我带来一个非常珍贵的零距离来接触这些病人的机会。
Dr. Xu arrives in Wuhan on the 14th of February. He immediately gets to work treating a wide range of COVID-19 symptoms.
很多病人表现这样那样的特殊痛苦，燥热、出汗、失眠，他会发现牙疼了，他会出现胃疼了，还有的病人他颈椎痛了，这个都要处理啊。某些人群的抵抗力体质弱，我们充分发挥中药独特优势，促进我们相应的内脏功能正常的活动，增强我们自身的免疫功能。
出汗呢，一个呢有点内热，一个呢有一点这个虚，这个又能补又能清热啊。那
这个要怎么办？
就冲嘛，开水一冲就行，很简单啊。
哦，好，谢谢。
Prescriptions are made up in a mobile pharmacy parked outside the hospital. It stocks 305 common Chinese herbal medicines. Rather than offering a ready-made drug, each is tailor-made for every patient. Dr. Xu believes this is key to the effectiveness of TCM.
We are through this, one person, one bottle. I hope you all, everyone, will be fast.也谢谢你们的配合啊。
Besides treating patients with milder symptoms, traditional Chinese medicine also plays a role in helping the more critically ill. Dr. Zhu Jia from Jiangsu Traditional Chinese Medicine Hospital is an expert in respiratory health. For him, this virus poses special challenges.
这次病毒它不仅仅是对我们的呼吸道进行了攻击，而且对我们的免疫系统有很大的损伤。他们比喻呢，对肺部的损伤像 SARS， 啊，对免疫功能的损伤像艾滋病毒，啊，所以治疗起来非常非常棘手，病人很容易转成重症。对于一些本来就免疫功能不好的病人，一旦感染以后，死亡率很高。
When he and 12 colleagues arrive in Wuhan, they team up with doctors using Western medicine. In small groups, they tour Hubei province, providing treatment plans that combine these two medical practices.
一些重症病人，特别是一些上了呼吸机的病人，呼吸机亢特别明显。那么这种情况，啊，我觉得我们中医就可以介入，采用了一些啊，这个宣肺通腑、化痰清热这样的一种。啊，方法，哎，病人大便通了以后，慢慢肚子胀缓解了，哎，氧就上来了，那呼吸机很快就开始拆掉。
For the less seriously ill patients, as well as prescriptions designed to restore general health and boost immunity, a series of gentle physical exercises and stretches is also used to aid recovery.
病人在打这些八段锦、太极拳的过程当中，他一方面心情安静了，心情有一种愉悦、积极向上的这个心态；另外，本身从打的这些过程当中，他就能够疏通经络啊，调节气血啊，促进他康复是有积极作用的。
开步，转身，摊牌，后坐。
In the ICU at Wuhan No. 1 Hospital, 34-year-old Dr. Jiang Qian, a specialist in geriatric medicine and critical care, is hard at work.
六十八号是吧？
对，
六
十八号
相对好一点。
Amongst the critically ill is Mrs. Fu.
我女儿还在方舱医院。
哦，哎，不哭不哭不哭！你看你女儿在方舱，就说明她的病情还比较轻，那她恢复就会很快，你知道吧？
好。
她也肯定很担心你，你在医院里面比她重一点。
对对。
知道，所以你一定要吃好睡好，还是那个好的。
好。
然后乖乖吃药，好不好？
好，谢谢。
这个老奶奶的爱人因为新冠已经去世了，然后她有一个8岁的小外孙女。那个小外孙女没有症状，是被社区隔离在其他的地方，她非常非常着急。 每一个医生去查房的时候，他都要反复的讲他的情况。
哦，不难过。
小女孩好可怜，
咱不难过，好不好？
我心里放不下去。
我们还是比较担心他肺的表现是比较重的，就怎么想的也要把这个老奶奶治好，要让他出院吧。
他那个小瑞农吃的不错，你要不给他一天三瓶，把他床梯子拍出来吧。
这个药是一天吃两次，一次吃一粒，早晚吃。
Mrs. Fu improves, but Dr. Jiang still visits her every day.
还好吧？
我还好，我现在就是有点干咳，你们要注意身体啊。
哦，好的。
因为你们光接触病人也是很危险的事。
All the medical staff here are under pressure, but Dr. Jiang is under extra strain.Shortly after arriving in Wuhan, her father, over 500 kilometers away in Nanjing, suffers a heart attack.
因为那天过来的时候，情况是不是很好？所以他视频的时候，一句话也没说就哭。
好了，好了，好了。
Dr. Jiang's hospital back home quickly provides her father with the operation he needs, setting her mind at ease.
He 接触到医院，我就放心了，因为他在医院里面会有些突发情况，医院会根据病人情况，然后再做特殊处理。而且他每天都在给我反馈。喂。喂爸，啊，你身体怎么样？
我现在基本上啊，好
啊。我跟你说，你这次还挺危险的，你知道吧？你一定要注意休息，按时吃药，不要抽烟了啊。
Knowing her father is recovering, Dr. Jiang can now fully focus her energy on her work in Wuhan.
上一班已经处理了，
但
我们这班要
检查。不等病人减少，然后不等武汉的疫情控制住，你是不可能回去的。
In Wuhan, many patients' lives still hang in the balance. Amongst them is 38-year-old Peng Bo.2 weeks ago, his doctor, Pan Chun, operated on him, connecting him to an artificial lung for a treatment known as ECMO. But there's been a sudden complication.
记得那天前一天晚上，当时呢，他就，当然因为他没有烧，他当时因为有 ECMO， 他的血要在外面转一下，量一下再回来，所以说他发烧我们是发现不了的，但是他感染指标在往上走，就是我们的一些感染发现感染指标往上走。而且呢，当时血压垮得很厉害。
Peng Bo is suffering from a bacterial infection. Dr. Peng is keen to keep him on the ECMO treatment to allow his body to rest and recover. But as his condition worsens, he's forced to make a difficult decision.
我说不能再等，我说必须撤掉。要不撤，这个可能人就没有了，就是我们前功尽弃。确实那个时候呢，我们面临大的风险，在于说呢，撤掉 ECMO 没问题，但是这肺能不能扛得住
？As the artificial lung is removed, Dr. Peng waits to see his patient's response.
但是还不错，其实撤了 ECMO 以后，还是反正每天得给他弄复位啊，弄完，还是至少他的呼吸功能其实能够慢慢的改善。
For now.Dr. Peng is able to relax. Despite the improvement in cases in Huangshi, Dr. Huang still remains on high alert. Tonight, a 58-year-old patient in the neighboring city of Daya has an acute respiratory failure. She and nurse Li Xiaoqing rush to perform emergency surgery.
因为时间比较紧，病人又比较重。
那么所以我们是颈内静脉穿刺和股静脉穿刺同时进行的。Dr. Huang carries out an almost blind puncture of one of the patient's major arteries. Only this way can she insert a tube to get oxygen into his blood. Despite the difficulty of the operation, the patient has come through. Back at their hotel, Dr. Huang and nurse Li have little time to rest as the emergencies come thick and fast. Another patient has developed a problem with his artificial lung. Dr. Huang must operate urgently to save his life. Dr. Huang must bring the new tubing packs the patient needs with her. Every moment now is vital. The operation is over. Dr. Huang is exhausted.
惊心动魄，但是顺利。<laughs>
Besides nerve-wracking operations, one of Nurse Lee's biggest challenges is persuading patients not to lose hope. She and her colleagues have come up with an ingenious way of keeping spirits up.
接管插管的病人，他在接上呼吸管路以后，其实那个管路整体是有一些重量的，会有些牵拉，病人就会觉得在嘴唇上的这个管子非常的不舒服。然后弄的那个手套充气起来正好，就像在那个接头的地方，可以减轻牵拉的重量，病人的舒适感会更好一点。今天也要加油，是不是啊？你听到我说话了是不是啊？你看看他眼睛大大的。 有的时候就是我们随口说说的鼓励，对病人来说，也是一种特别大的温暖和力量。所以呢，我们在那个手套的手指上面，或者是那个充气的手掌上面，都会画上笑脸呀，或者写上加油呀，画一朵春天的花朵呀什么的，写一些家里面人对他们的期望的寄语啊。
这是给你画的，那你多吃饭，要加油。
Nurse Lee's gentle coaxing pays off. Today, this patient has regained her appetite. But the patients aren't the only ones who need encouragement.
儿子画的《我想成为你》的那幅画，我真的是非常的感动。他在那个病人的床头画了太阳，那一轮太阳其实应该象征着儿子给我的鼓励。我就那一下子就觉得，其实他一直在默默的关注我，他知道我工作是多么的不容易。
While the hard work of the medics in Huangshe is paying off, The picture in Wuhan is also looking brighter. In the Dahuashan Cabin Hospital, it's an important day. 13 days after their admission, Dr. Shou's first patients are being discharged. Thanks to the medics' hard work, as of the end of February, over 30,000 patients have been discharged in Hubei. With the number of cases falling, the medics on Hubei's front line are turning the tide. At Wuhan's Jingyintang Hospital, the 4th of March is a good day for intensive care doctor Pan Chun. 24 days ago, he operated on a patient, Peng Bo, who'd been close to death. Since then, he's been in an induced coma on life support. Today, Peng Bo finally regains consciousness.
醒来，潘医生就拿这个手机，他鼓励我，他说：“你看你女儿给你录了视频，我放给你看。”当时我就哭起来了嘛，不受控制的。爸爸，我爱你，加油！加油！他说：“确实，我看了女儿照片，是给了我一个很大的动力。”But
he is not out of the woods yet. 3 days later, Peng Bo needs another emergency procedure. Dr. Pang anxiously observes.
在三月八号，病人就出现了消化道出血。我们晚上11点跑到那边去，赶快给他做了胃镜下止血。也是他大难不死，必有后福啊。
A few weeks later, Peng Bo's strength is finally returning, and he is learning to use his muscles again. His wife is due to give birth to their second child, and he's keen to get home. But his doctors are worried that he'll overreach himself and set his recovery back.
第一个问题，第一个营养，第二个睡眠，第三个运动。如果你一个康复，基本上最少做这个事情，其他事情交给我们。There's
also good news in Huangshe. More seriously ill patients are recovering, and some are returning home.
今天从黄石市中心医院传来好消息，四名危重症患者经过治疗之后达到标准，正式出院。
This patient is one of Dr. Huang's success stories. Today he is being discharged in good health.
被人推着进了 ICU， 然后我心里当时想着，我说我要么就不出去，我出去我一定要站着走出去。
In China's Hubei province, the epidemic is coming under control. But the improving situation isn't only due to the efforts of the doctors and nurses. Others are helping outside the hospitals. 8.8 million volunteers are working across China to transport the medics and deliver supplies of much-needed equipment, as well as providing medicine and groceries for those confined to their homes. In addition to this, teams of public health experts are also deployed to stamp out the virus in wider society. Their job is to disinfect anywhere the virus might be lurking and track and trace infections. With fewer people on the critical list, the medics have a little more time to spend keeping the patients company.
没有。
Li Juanjuan was the youngest nurse in her group of medics arriving from Jiangsu province. She struck up a special friendship with one patient in particular.
你知道我是谁吗？
江苏队小可爱。
你怎么哭了？
不哭。
没看到你们叫的很亲切。
亲切啊！
还有你们的耐心。
我们应该的，
这是我们应该做的，爷爷。
没有该做的，感谢你们，谢谢你们。
没事。
On the 15th of March, A video of Nurse Lee and her patient, who nicknamed her Cutie, goes viral on social media, attracting 100 million views.
爷爷很可爱嘛，我喊这个爷爷叫大可爱。这个爷爷来的时候，我看到他的病情也比较重嘛，我是看他一点点好起来，所以就觉得有不一样的感情吧。
The virus typically affects older patients most seriously. It's a source of great anxiety for many of them. So spending time with the medics is even more important.
我闲下来的时候会跟他们聊聊天啊，找一些开心的话题，然后会跟他们说，爷爷你住在哪里呀？以后我来武汉啦，会找你，你要带我去吃好吃的呀。你要让病人有生存下去的希望，照顾好每个人的情绪，我觉得就是最好的护理。
As things settle down inside the hospitals, there's some good news for the medics.
现在所在的位置呢，就是黄石市中医医院，这也是当地的传染病医院。今天该院的最后一名新冠肺炎确诊患者是顺利出院，这也是标志着黄石确诊病例和疑似病例实现了双清零。
The quiet wards and empty beds are a sign of a job well done. Just over a week later, on April the 5th, Pang Bo is finally leaving hospital. 78 days after he was first admitted.
重新自己走到医院大门口，看到马路，看到有车，看到天，看到树，真的是恍如隔世，感觉重新活了一盘。
就是你是我们应尽的责任和义务。
但在我一个病人来说的话，我不可能就这么想，我就觉得你们就是给了我第二次生命的人。
当时我鞠躬其实也挺困难的，哎，我的整个机体都不行，就是这个肌肉都萎缩了，骨骼也都有问题，那个时候关节都有问题，但是我是真心想跟他们鞠个躬。
经过76天的坚守，武汉与外界的通道今天重新开启。
On the stroke of midnight, after almost 11 weeks in lockdown, the city starts to come back to life. Transport systems spring into action as outbound roads, train stations and airports reopen.Shops and restaurants welcome customers back, and people are finally reunited with loved ones. For Wuhan, the light at the end of the tunnel is finally here. Amongst the 346 medical teams from across China that came to support Hubei, those from Jiangsu are the last to leave. It's the end of an extraordinary journey.
一路指引我，无论岁月变幻，爱你唱成歌。
听我说谢谢你，因为有你温暖了四季。谢谢你，感谢有你把幸福传递。
谢谢你，感谢有你，世界更美。
一路顺风。
In October 2020, Pang Bo meets Pan Chuen for the first time since he left hospital in April. They stay in touch by phone, but before now, he has never seen Dr. Pan without his mask.
这见到潘纯，我就说两次吧，激动、高兴，真的是还是非常非常感动的，也非常激动的，也非常自豪的。
我在病床上就跟这个潘教授他们说，我就说这样的，我说我这次能够平安出去，我说以后欢迎你们来武汉，我请你们喝茅台。
武汉人民还是说话算话的，哈哈哈哈哈。那武汉人自己先说话算话的。个人素质怕什么？我要喝完吧，你不喝完你喝。我想对这些医护说的呢，也没多少什么华丽的辞藻，我要去怎么样去赞美他，不是这样，我就真的是真心就是感谢他们。
It is not, however, only the patients for whom the COVID-19 epidemic has been life-changing.
我觉得更多的来讲，说只是说我们尽了医生该做的一点事，这是医生的职责，这是医生的责任，这是医生的担当。其实还是非常感慨的，在这个里面真的看到了很多很多的以前所没有看到的地方，所有人都很团结。
其实，在武汉，我觉得引以为豪的事情，其实就像我能真的看着我们每一个病人出院，我觉得这个事情是最高兴的事情。还有来一份。我可能不会忘记，会有一天做出这么一个决定，离开自己的家，去帮助更多的家，我会自豪，我会骄傲。
黄石有一条非常有名的樱花大道，因为3月8号是妇女节，然后他们说是不是大家能拍一张照片？酒店的服务人员还打趣说，平时如果樱花开成这个样子的时候，我们这儿简直就是人山人海的。他说今年的樱花只为你们医疗队开。
For the doctors and nurses of Wuhan, and the 42,000 medics who volunteered from across China, 2020 will be a year they will never forget. From discovering how to fight an unknown virus, to combining different medical practices, to working in new and collaborative ways, they found a path through the storm.